Hi guys, Codetutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. In the previous video, I have talked about what is service binding and why they are used. In this particular video, I want to concentrate on first way of binding, that is local binding using IBinder interface. First of all, we need to understand in which particular scenario we can use it. I have a service and an activity. Activity is the visible part and service is the invisible part which is executing in the background. What I will do is the service will be continuously generating a random number and it is under constant execution. That is, it is under infinite loop and generating these random numbers. The activity needs to display random number that has been generated in the service whenever it needs. For that, the activity needs to bind to that particular service. After successfully binding to that particular service, it basically will ask for a random number from the service. And if it is perfectly bound to that particular service, then service will return a number that has been generated at that particular point in time. The activity will receive that particular number and will display on that activity, that is UI. How do I accomplish this? Two-part implementation is, service needs to implement the onBind method and return a IBinder instance. And the activity need to use the service connection API to connect to the service. So let's first concentrate on implementing the service which returns a IBinder instance. For that, let us get into a demo. I will be reusing the code and modifying from the previous video. You can see that I have a private variable, instance variable, mRandomNumber. This will hold the random number that is being generated by the service. And this is a Boolean variable which I will be using to either switch on or switch off the random number generator. I have also declared two int constants, min and max. This I will be using to generate the random numbers between the range. So my random numbers that will be generated by the service will be between the range of 0 to 100. To start the random number, I have two methods, start random number generator and stop random number generator. In the start random number generator, I will check whether the Boolean variable is random generator on is true. If it is true, I will start generating the random number. I am using simple plain Java code to generate the random number. But I don't want this random number generation to be very fast. That is why I have made the thread to sleep for 1 second. And then I will log the random number to the logcat. I have got another method, stop random number generator. It will make the Boolean variable as false. Then I have also implemented a method called as get random number. This basically returns the random number that is being generated and being assigned in the start random number generator. When the service gets started, the onStartCommand method of the service gets executed first, and that is where I am starting the random number generator. You can see that I am making m is random generator on equals to true, and I am creating an instance of a thread and I am starting a thread. I should not write this particular method directly inside the onStartCommand because, as you are aware, that by default service runs on a main thread. So you don't want your random number generator to be running on the main thread and blocking the UI, which will surely lead to application not responding error. And on stop of the service, the onDestroy method will get executed. In that case, I am calling the stop random number generator, which will basically make this particular value equal to false. And that is when random number generator while loop will stop. Now comes the main part, which is implementing onBind method so that it returns a IBinder interface. Right now you can see that my onBind returns a null, but it needs to return a IBinder interface. For that, I need to create a class which implements IBinder. Let me create a class called myServiceBinder extends binder. Binder is a abstract class which extends the IBinder interface. So you can implement IBinder or you can extend binder. They are one and the same. In this particular class, you have to override a method getService. And what that particular getService will return is the service. So my service get service return my service dot this. This will basically return the my service instance. And now let me create a private instance of IBinder. Private IBinder mBinder is equal to and initialize it with my service binder. And you need to return the mBinder from the onBind. So we have successfully implemented a service which can receive the onBind request from an external agent. In this case, it is a activity. So let me run the code and see whether my service is generating the random numbers. You can see that my main activity thread ID is 1. So activity has started, and on click of this particular button, the services should start and I should be able to see the random numbers that are being generated. So click and you can see that the random numbers are being generated, and also you can see that I am displaying the thread ID, and thread ID is different than the main thread. And you can see that onStart command also has got the thread ID as 1. If I had not put random number generator on a separate thread, it would have run in the same thread ID as main activity, that is thread ID 1. So by doing this, I have avoided the application not responding error. And when I click on the off service button, the service should stop, and you can see that the service destroyed is the message that I am getting in the logcat. Next part is, in the activity, other than start service and stop service, I will have few more buttons, one to bind to a service and one to unbind from the service, and another button which will basically get the random number generated in the backend in the service and display it here in the text view that have on the activity. The remaining part of the coding I will show you in the next video, where I will wire up the all remaining code. You can see how a service and activity can bind work together. So that brings us to the end of this particular video. If you like what you've seen so far, subscribe, like, share and comment. Take care. Bye.